God, they will discern more than we have. After we first build our thoughts, and we can read this now, and then we will discern to be God, and the first God, and five in the second. Allahu Akbar. 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 Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Malik Yawm al-Din Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in اهدنا الصراط والمستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء نحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنب اللشك الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مفتوشة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إنا إلينا إيابهم ثم إنا علينا حسابهم. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة
السلام. السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. I request all the members who are standing in the back, please sit down and listen to the khutbah in its entirety. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له Washhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Amma ba'du fa'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim, Malik Yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas sirat wal mustaqim. Sirat wal lazina an'amta alayhim. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. We are gathered here today to celebrate that we have completed 1 month of a spiritual exercise which Allah Almighty told us in the Holy Quran. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam kama kutiba alal ladzina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. It is mandatory for all the believers who are in the age of adulthood that they are supposed to observe the month of fast. It is not something which is optional, that all believers must fast in the month of Ramadan. And the reason behind that is that Allah wants us to become the righteous people, a righteous nation. For saying so, it has brought to my attention that some member of our Jamaat, maybe there are very few, they do not take the month of Ramadan very seriously. They think that it is something that I can do, or if I cannot do, it is okay. And sometimes we as a parents become very lenient toward them. Okay, because now you are studying and now you are doing some hard work, so it is okay if you don't fast. But what the Holy Quran tells us, that when we say Atiullah, we should obey Allah, meaning all the commandments which are given to us in the Holy Quran, we must obey all those commandments. And this is come in the second of our Arkan-e Islam, is the fasting. With the time, thing changes. I know in early childhood in Rabwa and some who lived in Qadian, how they observed the month of fast. And now, after 100 years later, we are at a different stage, different country and different time. As I just mentioned in the very beginning, that it is obligatory for all believers, male and female, that they must observe in the month of fasting. As we see in the history, at the time of Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he fought 2 wars in the month of Ramadan. One is Ghazwa Badr and one is Ghazwa Tabuk. And imagine the hardship they were doing in case of war, and they were also fasting at that time. It's a message for us who are living in these Western countries that we must observe those values which we got from our parents, grandparents, from our elders. That the fasting month is a mandatory. All the members of our Jamaat who have skipped few days in the month of Ramadan. Now we have 11 more months to complete those days. Because Allah Ta'ala told us that if you are in a journey or you are sick, there is no exception. We still have to complete those days. And we have these 11 months now. So I will request all the young ones and who are healthy people and they were unable to fast, they must do their utmost to complete those days so we become righteous. And for those who has completed their whole month of fasting, may Allah Almighty accept their whole month of fast. And may Allah Almighty give them the strength and they continue in the spirit in the coming year. The philosophy of Eid means the days of happiness, which are coming and they are being repeated over two times for the believers. And once a week, the Jumatul Mubarak is also a day of Eid. So we are lucky this time that we are having the both days in one day. So it is optional for the believer that they can say, stay for Eid al-Fitr. And if they want to stay for the Jumatul Mubarak, it will be better. But if not, they can also leave if they are going to work and they offer their Salatul Zuhur. For them is also optional. Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has done both ways. So that's the reason I'm saying it is optional that on the day of the Eid al-Fitr and if Jummah gets unite, we have a second option. To control our desires. That is the key which we learn the message in the month of Ramadan. To control our desires. Not our desires are going to control us. There is a big difference, and that is the training which we get in the month of Ramadan. This one month was a training for us for the coming 11 month, that how we are going to live our life for the coming 11 month is going to be the result and the experience what we got in this month. We are offering Salatul Taraweeh, Salatul Tahajjud, and many Nawafal in this month. We must continue at least some portion of those spiritual experiences in our coming 11 month. And for us it's so important because there was a lady, a Japanese lady by the name of Miwa. She asked the Muslim, why do you fast? He said, we fast because there is a commandment in the Holy Quran that we should observe and stay away from food from morning till evening. And also not to get involved those things which are forbidden specifically in this month. Backbiting, taking advantage of other people, hurting other people, and many other ailments or the disease which we have among us. We try to skip from those in this month. Where the lady says, well, you are lucky that you have to do only once a month and we as a nation have to do it every day to be straight with our dealing with other people, not taking care of the advantage of the other people, not do the backbiting and make the life easy for the other people. It has been mentioned by Hazur and our Amir Sahib, the financial sacrifice, which is the second part. Salat and the month of Ramadan was the spiritual exercise, that we do those exercises with our body. And with that, we become the obedient to the commandments of Allah. And the second part is doing good with the people. And also do the financial sacrifice. We have got a letter from respected Amir Sahab, and I hope all the Jamaat members have got it. We, as a Jamaat, has to move far up on our financial sacrifice, because that is the one way to become righteous. That is the one way to purify our wealth. Because once we made a pledge with the Imam of the age, that whatever you are going to tell us, we're going to do it to the best of our ability. With that pledge, we gave our hand in the hand of the Imam of the age, and whatever you tell us, we'll do it. Whereas some of us are lacking in that financial sacrifice. At the time of Musa alayhi salam, they asked for the chanda. At the time of Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they asked for the chanda. And this time, when the victory of Islam is at the doorsteps, we're also being asked to do the financial sacrifice consciously. And he prescribed for us that if we earn $100, we will give 6.25. That is even less than the sales tax which you pay in the state of Pennsylvania. We got a note over here that people have parked their car in front of the dumpster. One is a Nissan Pathfinder, one is Toyota Sienna, Nissan, and Honda Accord. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, please go and move your car in front of the dumpster, because the guy is there to empty the dumpster. Jazakallah. With that, I go to the second part, which is our mosque. By the grace of Allah, many of us who are sitting here have been struggling to have a mosque for the Philadelphia. I remember since 1990, we have been trying to have a mosque, a build mosque in the city of Philadelphia. Our respected Naib Amir Mir Hamad Sahab, once we bought the building, which is now at 5120 North 10th Street, that was a huge sacrifice at that time for us to raise $42,000 at that time. People have done such a big sacrifice at that time from our standard, but the whole Jamaat was unable to raise that money. And still we have to borrow some from the headquarters to complete that deal. Now in 2018, by the grace of Allah, we are being blessed with a brand new mosque, the first mosque built in the city of Philadelphia, ground up. Alhamdulillah, as a Jamaat, we are proud of it. And all those members, male or female, children, they made all those sacrifices, those financial sacrifices, which I asked them one time, two times, three times, and many times. And they came up front on the plate, and they did their job. Jazakumullah, huwasul jazah, for all those who made the special sacrifices, unproportional of their earnings. People who are running the cabs, they come up with the big number. The people on the social security getting $800, making a pledge of $3,000, and the children. And the people who save their money for something else, they say this is the important. People sold their property, borrowed money, so we can fulfill our financial obligation. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, that we are able as a Jamaat to fulfill that pledge which we made lastly with the respected Amir Sahab. And we have done and finish that obligation. So from deepest part of my heart, I'm thankful to all Jamaat members, rich or poor, young and old. Barakallahu alaikum, that you have come and were able to have that beautiful mosque. Unfortunately, we were very close to have our this Eid at our new site, but there were still some issues, so we postponed it. But inshallah, we will have our next Eid at our new site. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Al-Khamis, Ajadallahu Ta'ala bin Asr Aziz, send us a name, and that is Masjid Baitul Afiyat. And that is in Urdu and in the English is going to be the same, Masjid Baitul Afiyat. The word Afiyat is mentioned in many places in the saying of Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. One time his uncle, Hazrat Abbas, asked him, O Messenger of Allah, tell me a prayer which should be very short for me and which have a big effect in my life. So Holy Prophet Muhammad Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told him that you ask in these words, Allahumma inni as'aluka afwan wa afiyata fi dunya wal akhirah. Deo, O Allah, forgive me and safety and peace from all type of calamities and all trial and tribulation. So I hope and pray that the name which is given to us by Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Al-Khamis is going to be placed for afiyat for all of us. In the last year, in the last few months, we have lost 4 members of our Jamaat. And I thought it is appropriate that I should share with you the one who lost, that who left from here and met the Lord in the paradise. First of them was Bilal Abdul Salam. He was here with us last year. We miss him dearly this time. A pioneer Ahmadi in Philadelphia Jamaat, serviced the Jamaat in many capacities. He was a missionary, coming to the mosque 8 o'clock in the morning till 5 o'clock, doing more work as compared to some of the missionaries which are working now, day in and day out. I met him first time in 1972 when I came to this country. A whole bunch of young people at that time, they were holding the banner of Ahmadiyyat at that time. One by one, we are losing them now. And we are looking for the new converts. For that, it is a big responsibility on us to take the tabligh seriously. Because once they leave and we don't have the people to replace them, it will be a sad situation for us. We have a new mosque. We got to populate it, not with the Ahmadis who migrated from the other part of the world, from the people who live in this country. So we have to convey the message with the prayers. The O Allah Almighty, we have made this place, and you are the one who is going to change the heart. So we should must pray. But Uncle Bilal has a great desire. He spends his day in and day out at the new mosque site, sitting over there and praying for the victory of Islam. With his death, he gave us a message. The message must continue. And it is our responsibility as the Ahmadis to take the banner from him and continue the message what he was giving. Secondly, our dear sister Salma Ghani, she was very dear to me and especially the member of the Lajna, a pious person, offering tahajjud prayer. If somebody have seen her, or she was offering her salat in such a humble way, it bring the tears in our eyes. She left us too this year also. And the third one is Rashid Bhatt Sahib, one of the early Ahmadis who migrated in 1974 or 75 in Philadelphia. And he made this city his home and lived his whole life. He was teaching the Holy Quran. He has done the best he can do for the Jamaat. And also the last one, very recently, Mubashshar Ahmed Sab Nasser. He was one of the active members of our Jamaat, always available to me whenever I need any help. He just stands up and gets up and starts moving and doing whatever he has been told to do so. And lastly, our member is Muhammad Bashir Sahab, who also lived long time in the city of Philadelphia, very active member of our Jamaat. He migrated to Phoenix, Arizona, very past few days ago. I think we were not able to offer his namaz janaza ghaib. So inshallah, we will offer his namaz janaza ghaib right after Juma and Asr prayer. Lastly, the time comes that all the Jamaat, we have to get together, forget our differences now, and make our goal to do the message of Tabligh. I know we think that the people who are dying, it is their responsibility. It is the responsibility of each and every Ahmadi. Khalifatul Masih II, he told us very clearly, it's not the job of the Muballigin. At that time, there were 300 to 400. Now they're big in number. But he put the responsibility on each and every member of the Jamaat. Please listen carefully. This is our duty and responsibility at this time. We are going to have a big opportunity in a couple of weeks that we are going to move into the new mosque. We need the volunteer, whether they have any knowledge about Islam and Ahmadiyya, make no difference. But if they are coming to the mosque, just populate the mosque. That is one way to do the tabligh. And secondly, who are learned, they should come forward and move on the footstep of Badr Bilal Abdul Salam, especially of African American. They have a bigger responsibility now. After Bilal Sab left us, they should come forward, because it is easy to give a message to those people who speak the same language, same values, and same way of understanding about things. If I convey the message, it might have some effect for the African American. But if an African American, brother and sister, going to give the message, it will have double, triple effect. Lajna Maula, they have also big responsibility in this regard. Let's get together now. It is 100 years ago when Mufti Muhammad Sadiq Sahib came to this country and brought the message of Islam and Ahmadiyya in this city of Philadelphia. This is going to be our 100 year celebration now, that we will get up, move, and motivate us and our children to come in this fight, to come in this jihad, and leave up to Allah how many souls we are going to collect with our effort. It is up to Allah who is going to change the heart. It is up to Allah who is going to change the heart of the people. It is up to the Allah who is going to change the heart of the people. But our responsibility is to convey the message with the prayer and with the pain that these people who are so good, so nice, many great values they have as Americans. As Mufti Muhammad Sadiq Sahib talked in 1920 about the American values at that time, they are still valid. And they are honest people. And the honest person, when he gets the message, honestly, they ponder over and they listen to the message. And that's the way it's going to be the conversion now. In Pakistan, in those countries, we have been banned to convey the message of Ahmadiyya. But here, nobody has tied up our hand with the power of the law. Nobody is stopping us to convey this message, the beautiful message. If we can save one life, bring to the fold of Islam, as if we have conquered the whole city, this should be the idea in our mind. At least I will try one. Just we have to try for first month, and inshallah, then we start the chain reaction. That the people who accepted Islam, Ahmadiyyat, they will come, and they will come with a big force, and they will convey the message to their close relatives. As a Jamaat, we are supportive of our new converts and who are in Ahmadiyyat at this time. If they want to bring their brother and sisters and their cousin to their home, what we can do as a Jamaat, we can make the food for them and call them, and if they need any member of the Jamaat who is learned and who can convey the message, we are ready for that. But the biggest message we have is our own example. If we have made that change in us, that the other people look toward us and they say, I want to be like that person. That is the real tabligh. But if the other people think that he is just among us and he has labeled him or her as a Ahmadi, it's not going to work now. We have to live as a living example. So the people see us and they say, I want to be one of those. And we have to increase our spirituality in this regard. And we have to do whatever the sources we have. At least if we cannot go for the tabligh, if we are sitting home, we can pray. Oh Allah, all those who have taken this challenge, going on the street in the trailer, on the corner, meeting the people, make their efforts successful. That is the least what we can do if we are not doing and actively involved in the tabligh. That was the last message I want to convey to the Jamaat members. And we are going to reach into our new mosque very shortly. And we need more and more volunteer in all different fields. So please do not hesitate. Nobody else is going to come and support the cause of the Promised Messiah alayhi salam. We as an Ahmadi have a double responsibility, and we should be all ready that in our 1 year time, 2 year time, at least we convert one soul. And there are souls in the city of Philadelphia who are looking for truth, but they haven't got the message. We have to search those souls with our prayers and try our best that this city was the desire of our late Naib Amir Munir Hamid Sahib, that this is the only city where the possibility that we can change the whole city and can bring them into fold of Islam and Ahmadiyyat. I request the Jamaat member to be actively involved in that. I request all the Jamaat members to specially pray for that and put all their efforts in this regard. May Allah Ta'ala help us to do so. Lastly, requesting for the prayer at this time as Hazrat Khalifatul Masih today shared with us in his khutbah that this is the last day for those who were fasting today. They had a one more day extension, the 30th fasting day, and they have a more opportunity because they are still in the month of fast. But as Hazur brought our attention, to offer those special prayers, we should remember all the members of our Jamaat in Philadelphia, then all the Muslims in the city of Philadelphia. Remember all the officials of our Jamaat. They are trying their best. Sometimes we have shortcomings. So please pray for the Amla members in our Jamaat and for the city of Philadelphia and for our country. It is a big, huge country, have too much influence all over the world. And if we pray, with our prayer, inshallah, this country will be a superpower. But we pray that Allah hold their hand of their aggression. Because sometimes when you get strong, you use your muscles. And that we have seen it in many years in Iraq, in Syria, in Yemen, and many other parts of the world. So we should pray for the Muslims living in those countries, in those sad, sad situations. very recently, things have gone worse in Yemen again. Thirdly, we should remember all the Ahmadis living all over the world, because they need our prayer, especially the members of Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, and the other country where we are being suppressed. Indonesia is one of the countries very recently that Ahmadis are being oppressed in that country at this time. No doubt, all the prophets, when they came, they were being oppressed, but eventually they become victorious. We should have that power in us. We have seen the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he was in Makkah, was being oppressed in Makkah, but he became victorious. Hazrat Imam Hussain was suppressed in the Karbala, but his sacrifice, his martyrhood raised the level of the Muslim. At this time we are being oppressed. Why we are being oppressed? Because we are on the right path. When you are on the right path, people will try to take you away from that path. We have to be firm and strong, and we should have love and affection in our families, with husband and wife, with our children, with our close knit family and extended family. We should remember all those in our family, that may Allah Almighty keep them happy, healthy and prosperous. And also remember those who have given their life for the sake of Ahmadiyyat in Pakistan and many other countries. We should remember the Waqfin and all those children. And we should remember those who are at this time in the age of marriage. There are hardships with many families. In many homes, the boys and the girls, they are in the age of marriage, and somehow, some way or the other way, are not being matched. So we should pray for those families, that may Allah Almighty give them the mate, whether they are the boys and the girls. And lastly, we should pray for the victory of Islam, that O Allah, show us the days in our life that we will see those days, that we can see with our own eyes the victory of Islam in America and all over the world. May Allah Almighty help us to do so.
Amen.
Amen. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله اكبر. Now we're going to have a silent prayer, so please remember our Khalifa, our leader, in our prayer, that may Allah strengthen his hand and he show us the path to the victory of Islam. Please join me in the silent prayer, dua. آمين اللهم آمين. عيد مبارك. And we have a couple of announcements.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.